Good evening, America. My name is Rudolph Splitzen, and this is CNN Nightly News. We are coming at you live this evening, exclusive from Vashon Island, Washington, with some exciting new footage and updates regarding this year's campaign and presidential election. Today was filled with much activity on the political front, starting off with incumbent President Mary Washington delivering a riveting speech to citizens attending the Ohio State Fair in Columbus, Ohio. Here's staff reporter Quail Quagmire with the full scoop. Quail?
Thank you, Rudolph. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and good evening. My name is Quail Quagmire, staff reporter here for CNN. I'm coming at you this evening live from Washington, D.C., where I have the privilege of bringing to you the scoop of today's happenings. It's been a very busy day for me here on the political front and for America, and I've spent much of my day actually traversing much of the East and Midwest of America, starting off my day in Ohio, where I had the lovely honor of attending the Ohio State Fair, where I saw Mary Washington deliver a very nice speech to help sway some citizens in Ohio in order to get her vote. Because Ohio, as you know, is a swing state, and it's very important if candidates want to get votes that they try to convince those swing states to go to one side or another, so they could maybe perhaps gain some more support in their campaign. Anyways, yes, Mary Washington, I saw her deliver a very nice speech there today at the Ohio State Fair. By the way, if you're ever in Columbus, be sure to try out the State Fair, the elephant ears at the State Fair. Oh, to die for. I must say, breaking news, America, Ohio State Fair has marvelous elephant ears. And the tilt-a-whirl, that's quite fun too. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, back to politics. Although there are some current lawsuits going against that tilt-a-whirl that has some political aspect to it. Anyways, that is not the story. I did hear, indeed, Miss Washington give her speech earlier today in the Ohio State Fair. And the footage that I took is not the best footage, because one of her main points, actually, in her speech was the economy. She talked quite a bit and elaborated on how she would like to help shape up the American economy in the next 4 years if she's elected again, and also what she has done to help the economy in her last 4 years' term as president that she is just completing. And, so speaking of the economy, CNN, well, you know, we've been in a recession in America in recent years, and, CNN has not been immune to that recession. Our budget has been affected a bit, and so as you can see, we do not own the kind of, perhaps, quality reporting instruments that, an organization of our caliber should own because of our budget is suffering along with the recession. So please bear with me for this next set of, this next reel of footage here. It's a bit deficient, but I think you'll be able to make it out anyways. So here is our president, Mary Washington, delivering her very exciting and invigorating speech at the Ohio State Fair.
Oil, clean coal, natural gas, and 2 million Americans into jobs for more need at our community colleges, and cutting the growth of tuition in half so that more students in America can afford it. Fourth, we need to create a balanced plan to reduce our deficit by $4 trillion over the next decade. On top of the trillion in spending we've already cut, I'd ask the wealthy to pay a little more. And as we end the war in Afghanistan, let's apply half the savings to pay down our debt and use the rest for some nation building right here at home. It's time for a new economic patriotism, one rooted in the belief that growing our economy begins with a strong, thriving middle class. I know that as we as a country continue to improve over the next 4 years, Americans will do what they've always done. And we come together.
Thank you, Quail. That was lovely footage. Now, is it true that afterwards, after that riveting speech delivered by Mary Washington, you actually got the chance and opportunity to interview her?
Why, yes, Rudolph. As a matter of fact, I did get to interview our President Mary Washington afterwards. She was in very good spirits, having just witnessed some of the biggest pumpkin contest and all of the wonderful happenings at the fair. I think she was enjoying her day at the fair. If I do say so myself, she needs to have a little fun now and then. I mean, she is the president, but she's also human after all, aren't we all? I had some fun at the fair. I mean, no, I didn't. I was working. Anyways, yes, I did get to interview Mary Washington. Quite a charming woman there.
Oh, fascinating. Well, let's see that. Roll tape.
Miss Washington, what sort of things have you and your campaign team been doing to sort of amp up your campaign since you found out who your contender will be in the general election since it was decided at the Republican primaries?
Yes, well, we have been doing a lot of stuff. We are very, very excited for this general election. We have been on the campaign trail nonstop. We are in Ohio right now. I just attended the Ohio State Fair, which was wonderful. And we are out talking to voters, thinking about what sort of issues matter to them. And we have several more states on our itinerary for the next couple weeks. We're going to be airing ads, giving speeches, and of course we are very, very excited for the general debates.
All right, thank you, Miss Washington. And that was a lovely speech you gave earlier, by the way, and here at the Ohio State Fair. And what has your favorite attraction been at the Ohio State Fair so far?
Well, it's all so much fun. I'm not even sure how to choose. What I love about going all over the country, regardless of where it is getting to talk to Americans from all different walks of life and from all different places around this great nation. And what I really see from Ohio is a dedication to hard work, to forging your own path. And what I see are people who are ready to work for the benefit of this country, just like I am. And it is so inspiring for me, and I get the sense that the next 4 years are just going to be wonderful and nothing can stand in our way.
Very nice. But the biggest pumpkin contest was pretty entertaining too,
wasn't
it?
That was incredible. I have never seen a pumpkin with a 15-foot diameter. I don't know how they did that, but I guess that is just a sign of the Ohioan hard work ethic.
It was impressive indeed. Well, thank you for joining us here today for these questions, Miss Washington. And good luck to you on the rest of your endeavors.
Thank you again, Quail. It's always interesting to hear what our president has to say on the matter, but I also hear that you got the good fortune of talking to, Mr. Taylor Hansen and his campaign manager, Maddie Royal. Is that so?
Why, yes, Rudolph, as a matter of fact, I did get to interview Hansen and Royal as well. A remarkable duo, Royal and Hansen. Work very well together. Nice to talk to.
Oh, well, that's wonderful. It's always good to have multiple perspectives on these things. It's always interesting, I think, to hear the opposing candidates' views on speeches that the other candidates give.
Yes, Rudolph, I'd have to agree. It is quite interesting to hear the opposing candidates' views on the other candidates' speeches. I love election years. It makes my job very interesting. Plus, I get to travel, as I did today. And, yes, very interesting indeed to hear opposing views. And, here is the clip now. Marge, show them the tape.
So, thank you for joining us today, Mr. Hansen and Miss Royal. And, although you guys weren't able to attend the Ohio State Fair and hear Mary Washington's speech in person, you did get to hear it by other means, and What are your opinions on that? What did you think of her speech?
It was alright. One of her main points was that she's actually raised the unemployment rate in Ohio. And a few minutes later, we checked that online, and in fact, she did raise them. But 2 years later, they plummeted again right back to where they were. So she hasn't done much over time.
Yes.
All right. And do you have any further comments on that?
I would just say that her four-point plan, I think it was a four-point plan, from what I remember, I think it lacked some of the, like, meat of what we need in our country, including a specific plan for getting people employed again, like Taylor Hansen has a specific plan, and that was one of our main things. And also the auto industry, as she's been president, it's been sort of plummeting, and she didn't even refer to that, and so we have a plan for that too.
Oh, so you feel Miss Washington perhaps left some things out and only centered on the obvious
on the things
good
that made
points.
Her look good.
Ah, I see.
One other thing is that the representative of Ohio, I spoke to him shortly after the speech as well, and he said he didn't particularly enjoy it. I don't think he was quite fully satisfied.
Interesting. And now, you mentioned she mentioned the economy in her speech, and you have a very different plan than Mary Washington in to restore the economy, and you always explain it so eloquently. Would you mind explaining to our viewers just briefly how it works?
Yeah. So what she attacked was that the trickle-down effect, in fact, does not work. What I think is that if you do cut taxes to the higher class, then they have more money to put into their businesses, because naturally it's the people with higher income that can afford those businesses. And then once they put more money into them, that money trickles down into the workers, and they get that money, and then they can buy products, and so it's just this positive growth that we're getting.
I see. Well, that is a very interesting plan. Thank you for joining us here today, both of you, Miss Royal, Mr. Hansen, and good luck, best of luck to the both of you on the rest of your endeavors on this campaign.
Thank you.
Well, thank you very much, Quail. That was very interesting. And now I hear you have got the opportunity to interview one more person, and this one might come as a bit of a surprise to you viewers. His name starts with an M, and so does his last name. You may have seen him in the news a lot last week, and the week before that, and the week before that, but lately, not so much. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, it's Mark Mills, who was running against Republican candidate Taylor Hansen, as the other Republican candidate wanting to have his go at running for president, but unfortunately for him, he lost the Republican primary debate and election last week, so he is no longer in the race. But he is still very supportive of his fellow Republican, Taylor Hansen, who is now running against incumbent president, as I'm sure you all know, Mary Washington, for the general presidential election of 2012. And, Quail, as I understand it, you actually got the opportunity to interview Mark Mills for his opinions on the recent developments in the political playing field, is that correct? Why, yes, I did get to interview Mills as well. It was a day of many interviews for me today, one of the exciting parts of my job. So yes, I did get to interview Mills. It was quite interesting, you know, seeing him again. We haven't heard from him for about a week now, since he's been off the ballot. And he looks like he's handling himself quite all right, though. He was talking about how he's now very supportive, actually, of fellow Republican Taylor Hansen, and he talked a little bit about how he now endorses him as president, and I got to talk with him very briefly about that too, and actually Hansen happened to be there. They were both in the Capitol building in Washington, D.C., taking care of some things together. Oh, well, excellent. Let's take a gander at that news clip now, shall we? Craig, roll tape!
Hello, I would just like to say that Taylor Hansen, the better man, won in this case, and I am officially endorsing him as a better president than Washington.
All right, and have you any comment on that, Mr. Hansen?
I'm sorry, I was a little distracted. There was a camera flashing in front of my face. Can you repeat the question?
Oh, do you have any comment on what Mr. Mills here has just had to say about his endorsement of you?
I appreciate the endorsement. I think it'll definitely help in the coming election. He was a formidable opponent.
All right, well, thank you for joining us here today. Oh, very nice.
So there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. That was Republican candidate Taylor Hansen and former Republican nominee candidate Mr. Mark Mills. So that's about it for tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm coming to you from the East Coast time, about 3 hours later than it is for you, Rudolph, and on Vashon, Washington. So I'm about ready to hit the hay here, but thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Again, I am Quail Quagmire, and this is CNN, bringing you the truth. Thank you very much, Rudolph, for having me, and good night, ladies and gentlemen. Until next time, I'm Quail Quagmire. Keep on keeping on. Thank you very much, Quail. Ladies and gentlemen, Quail Quagmire, giving you the scoop. So, I suppose that now concludes our news broadcast for this evening. Thank you very much for joining us here at CNN. My name is Rudolph Splitzen, and this is CNN, bringing you the scoop and the truth. Straight up! Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and see you next time.